good things happen when you have an environment of commitment and dedication. Not just talked about, but lived. Lessons of our past, issues of our future.
Hello, everyone. I'm Curtis Fuller, and welcome to Issues. Today, we're going to talk about an issue so critical in this city, and that's about our young people and what are we doing to respond to their needs and what the needs are throughout the city. Safety issues, education issues, and job issues. Almost sounds like a politician or something, you know, but these are critical issues for our city. And here to talk a little bit more about that, first of all, from the Cincinnati Police Department, Officer Andre Ewing. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about what he's doing within the police department and also throughout the city. Next to him, we have Reverend Tyrone Gray from Shepherd Heart Christian Fellowship. And last but not least, Reverend Alan Middleton from Galilee Baptist Church. And first of all, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
We'll start this by giving a little background first about you, Officer Ewing, how this whole notion of taking back our youth, how that all evolved.
Just evolved from my 16-year career, watching the youth in our city, watching the family issues that are taking place on a regular basis, and just wanting to implement something that everyone can be involved in, especially our parents and the community, of saying, what more can we do as a unit to take back our youth?
Mm-hmm. Now, and it's fair to say that this has been something that a lot of people have said, let's address this. What are we doing with our young people? But your point is, we have to just go to another level. This effort is, the goal is to make this more than anything we've seen in the past.
Correct. I first wanted to do what I call ride-alongs, because we all have a perception of everyone else's job and things that we see. So I said, let me call pastors up and say, do you know exactly what we do? And to implement that, when they decided to say, let's do a ride along and ride right next to me in the seat, now it becomes more real. So now I didn't want to give the perception that we just go out and decide that we want to just shoot individuals for no reason or what have you, and have that perception of the police, and that pastors only come around when there's a critical incident. But let's do some preventative work together. And once the pastors came out and did the ride along, the program just started to explode.
Now, did he put you in the front seat or did he put you in the back seat? You know,
I was in the front seat. He was in the front seat right with him.
Yeah, what's that like? Now, we've done that from when we ride along with the media.
It was a real experience. It was a real experience. And like Officer Ewing said, a lot of people have that perception that police is just, all they do is arrest people and shoot people all day, you know. So, you know, to sit there in that car and listen to all the calls that comes in, you know, all the violence that's actually happened that these officers have to face every day, was a real experience. That was a real experience.
Because a lot of it doesn't hit the headlines. It's not making
the
news. A lot of the domestic violence calls just a lot of things that start out in many cases small that can escalate very, very quickly. And so you're getting a chance to see that firsthand.
Yes. Yeah.
I think it's a big difference in, like, with the ride along. Had a chance to not only ride in the car, but at one point that there was a situation that we responded to, and had an opportunity to get out of the car, talk to the individuals involved, and help to allay the tension and all that was there. Remarkable how the officers were able to interact, you know, with the people in a calming sense. And I think, and in one incident, one day we ended up taking a young fellow over for a job interview because he missed his ride, you know. Mm-hmm. But little things that happen that make a difference that people aren't necessarily aware of.
And since we're talking about this, it's important, it's a little off subject a little bit, but it's important because when you get on the scene, so much is going on. You have to be forceful, but you want to be respectful, but you have to get things under control, find out what's going on. And I think most time people underestimate how fast you have to do that. Yeah.
Correct. Correct. Because we're really always on the defense because you don't know what you're really getting into. And so if you have a radio screen that says in front of you, domestic violence, the husband is screaming at the wife, and then they hung up the phone. So you don't know what's going to happen at that point. So you have to basically assess it and walk into it, and with much prayer, you know, hope that the situation does not escalate out of control.
Yeah. This Take Back the Youth, you had a program where you did a program up in Dayton, and that evolved to something that occurred this past February, and now we're looking at something that's going to be very huge in October. Talk about, we'll fast forward to what took place in February. Talk a little bit about that.
Well, in February, we decided the West Side churches, primarily of Cummingsville, North Fairmount, South Fairmount, the Millvale area. The churches came together as one, decided to go to the Cincinnati Christian University to do a Taking Back Our Youth and do workshops. And the workshops included information that parents could be more involved in as well to take to their youth. So people just think that it was just involving the youth, but it also, these workshops had titles that dealt with drugs and suicide, life as a teen, and preparing youth for job success. And we're implementing those type of workshops and also employment that day now, which is going to be very intense because we're going to need businesses to say we are ready to interview and hire people that day. And so we will definitely be taking their information as well, as this is becoming a community event because the chief now recognized we don't want to just have District 3 by itself, which was a pilot, but we want to implement all five districts in the entire city and Hamilton County.
We're going to take a break. Then when we come back, I want to talk about it's important to have churches involved, faith-based organizations involved, but that's not the easiest task because bringing different churches and organizations together, easier said than done, but it's working. Yes. Maybe it's because he has a gun. We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Curtis Fuller. October 27th is an important date because an event's going to take place at the Duke Convention Center downtown. It's called Taking Back Our Youth. I can call it part two because there was an event back in February over on the west side of town, an exciting day. You almost had to be there to understand what transpired that day. Getting churches involved, faith-based organizations involved, I know from your standpoint there's a desire to help, but getting people together is easier said than done. How has this worked? How has Officer Ewing been successful in making this work?
Well, I met Officer Ewing, and our community is the Westwood community, right, which they was moving up to. We wasn't actually involved in this just yet. But I met Officer Ewing, and I was listening at the program that he was offering, and we was trying to do the same thing in Westwood because Westwood is seeing quite a bit of this youth violence that is going on, along with the drugs. All that stuff has increased in that area in the past years, you know. So I was very interested in it, and being a church of 7 years in this community, that's exactly what we've been trying to work on. So when he mentioned this, that was just right down our alley where we wanted to go as far as the youth is concerned, because we've been working with the youth ourselves quite a bit, you know. So as far as the minister is concerned, he pulled me out of that community. He asked me, he said, you know what, we got this organization going on, and we'd like to get the minister's involvement in this, you know, because the minister's is the one that's really out there trying to do the work, you know, in the community to try to bring these youth in, you know, trying to save them, trying to save their lives. And I was very impressed with what they have done thus far, you know. So we have been involved with it from that standpoint.
What about you? Yeah.
Well, Andre and Captain Neville came by the church one day and kind of shared their vision for the youth and all. It reminded me of time years ago when I lived in Indiana, worked for the Urban League, and we were in a conference, and we did a test of the guys who were there, and we were trying to determine what were the primary concerns of people who were a part of the gang. You know, and, you know, do I want to be able to find a place to fence my goods that I steal? Do I want to find an easy mark and all this kind of stuff? And we put down our selections and handed them in. And then they handed back the gang members' response to the same questions. It ended up that the fella in the gang wanted to live in a good community, wanted to have a decent income to support his family, wanted his children to grow up without a lot of hassles and other things that were around. And, you know, and everybody started scratching their heads and said, wait a minute, they want the same things that I want. Mm-hmm. Now, the church's part is to help provide a vehicle for them to get those same things without the challenges that they would encounter in the street. And so our primary thing, again, is the scripture. You know, every Sunday we're saying, yes, Jesus loves me. And I remind them, he loves me exactly as I am, but he loves me too much to leave me that way. And so we began to introduce some things that can help change ideas, thought patterns, and habits, and draw them into a more solid culture, you know, and surround them with a godly love that can make a difference.
And I think in our conversations, that's an important element, that we can have all these programs, but you're saying at the start, God has to be a part of this solution. Is that?
Yes, definitely. As we go as police officers and say we enter people's homes, imagine there is information available that most of the runs we attend are like just family troubles, people trying to work out their issues. So we have developed information in Espanol as well, and Spanish, that we will go into the people's homes and say, if there's a desire or issue that you have, this church right down the street from you can give you family counseling, can give you things dealing with food, can give you information and resources that will help provide that you can also participate in the community. But what is interesting, once they come into the church, now the church pulls out that individual's gift that they want to provide something as well.
Hmm. And Chief Craig has been instrumental in making sure that this stays on the front burner. And you know, back in, I guess it was March or April, he went over into Avondale and really saw the issue there. He said, I think 52 churches in Avondale.
Right.
And he said, as many people have said, look, if you got 52 churches here, that's a great starting place, and we need to utilize you. So while this started on the west side, it's now broadened out into really citywide. And he said, you know, let's have a point person. So he then selects you to be the liaison between the police and the community and the faith-based organizations. I mean, that really shows his commitment to this.
Yes. Yes, he is definitely committed. And just, you know, that he saw how Captain Neville was committed even before he had stepped into it, that shows that the district commanders of each district have to be involved. And once Chief Craig saw that there was a great need for this, he now has called on it citywide, calling all pastors, the entire community, and everyone that wants to see a difference, not just in Cincinnati, but around the entire city and areas in Hamilton County as well.
Yeah, he's like E.F. Hutton. Mm-hmm. When he speaks, people listen.
Yes, sir.
I don't want him to call you at home. He might do that, too. So we'll be back in a moment. Welcome back, everyone. We're talking about an event coming up October 27th at the Duke Energy Center, Take Back Our Youth. It's going to be an all-day program. Let's walk through what's going to take place that day.
Well, we're going to have, doors are going to open around 8 a.m., and we're going to have a morning service that will start around 9:30 a.m., and it's going to be an emotional, powerful service. Not just a normal church service, but something that will be what I would want to call a pep rally to say this is what we're going to do to take back our youth. And from the morning service, we have a powerful, dynamic speaker, Timothy McDonald, coming in from Atlanta to speak. And we're just having a large day of workshops that will be involved as well. And some of these titles mm-hmm. that we have included, we have even Dr. Bobby Hilton that will be conducting one of the workshops, and Fighting the Dog in Me. And it's men only. And it's just dealing with the things and challenges that
particular workshop.
That particular work is men only. But we also have something that deals with women. Scream, Can Anybody Hear Me? And so we are dealing with real issues for real people that not only youth, but adults deal with. And to be able to come together in a group to express that, but not just workshops. You know, we're doing things that, say, preparing you for job success, employment that day, as mentioned earlier, and just a lot of powerful things of people. Pastor Damon Lynch III will be involved in gang prison life. Hmm. The Street Has Raised Me by Mr. Stan Ross. Just some powerful workshops for any problem that you have pretty much come across that will be there. But to also have things involving for the young kids, activities, dealing with boxing and as an expo. So it's just going to be an amazing event for anyone to come down.
And while there's this focus on youth, we've clearly heard that the title could easily be Take Back the Family
mm-hmm. yes.
as much as Take Back mm-hmm. the Youth, because, you know, they're not out there by themselves. They're seeing things in their schools and their community and their families. Sometimes they're seeing things in their church. Mm-hmm. Some have yes. wanted to get back in the church, but maybe they're seeing something
yes.
in there that's keeping them away. And so it does seem like a day long of sort of a cleansing day, and that's yes. how we should see it, as a community cleansing day, where we come in there, let some things out, and there's that opportunity for that. Yeah, and obviously your churches will mm-hmm. be involved.
Yes, we have not only do we have the workshops, and that's what our focus is getting these kids into the workshops, and approaching the problems that they have, directing to them, you know. But we also have entertainment part of it also. It's not going to be just all workshops. You know, we're going to also have praise dancers, and we also, they're assembling a 500 member choir to also sing. You know, there's going to be exhibitions that's put on boxing, things for everybody, mm-hmm. every part of that group, from young to old. There'll be something there entertaining for them also. But the main focus is going to be, of course, the workshops, trying to help these kids find themselves, you know, or the problems that they do have.
Right.
But we're going to have a host of things, and we do have a very good program set up that's going to take place during and after the workshop.
Absolutely.
So it's going to be entertainment also.
Yeah. And as I said, we got one of the things I think that needs to happen. If I don't acknowledge that I got a problem or that there is a problem, nothing ain't gonna get fixed. Okay, so a part of this is to, you know, bring up some things And you recognize, I'm recognizing some things that are off kilter. Now, rather than just point at, that's a shame, no, I'm going to give you something that's going to make a necessary difference. Mm-hmm. And so I'm not just saying, you know, I'm going to pray for you, baby. You know, but you know, I'm going to give you some clothes to put on. Right. I'm going to put some food on your table. Right. Then I'm going to put some information in your mind, you know, that you can carry with you as you move forward. And then I'm going to work with you as well. I'm not just going to do the conference and leave. There's follow up.
Yeah. And they have to work with you. I mean, this is a two-way street.
Exactly.
And so often it's not just about, you know, providing you everything. You have to take a few steps yourself.
Yeah.
And the first step is to come, you know, and that's easy. It's all free.
Free event.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Everything will be free.
Yeah. And I mean, just listening to some of the speakers and the workshops, I mean, yeah, you know, that's a powerful opportunity. These people speak all over the world.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
And fortunately, many of them live right here in Cincinnati, and we can tap into them, and they can be a part of this. But this is a great opportunity. It's all free. Let me give a number, 513-591-2692, extension 5. If you want to get more information, again, let me give that again, 513-591-2692, if people want to get information. And if other churches want to get involved, how can we get our young people down, right?
Yes, we're also going to have through Pastor Sutherland, and we're going to have an array of information that anything that they have links connected with Duke Energy.
Oh, excellent.
That they will be able to, we have transportation that we're going to provide. We're working with the City Metro on this. This is going to prove what happens when an entire city pulls together as one.
Good place to end, and we'll be talking much more about this, but I'm glad we got it out. You got October 27th. That's the key date. We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back. As we wrap up, let me give you that telephone number first of all. It's 513-591-2692. This is for Take Back the Youth, Duke Energy Center, October 27th. All day event, all free. A lot of great speakers. We also mentioned that we want businesses to contact so we can get some jobs for our youth and people throughout the city. Have a nice day, everyone.